All right, how does this work, Charles? How do you do single link clustering? Again, assuming the distances are distances in the plane, just because it makes it easy.
Right. So you just keep finding the clusters that are closest, and you defined it as where the two closest points in two clusters are what make them is what defines their distance. And so if I look at this, if you look at the big outer circle, you'll notice that each of you start with any one of those points, and it's always going to be closer to one of its neighbors on the circle than to say those four points in the middle of the circle, right?
They're close to each other.
They're
Well,
close to
so
each other.
if we start doing mergings, it ought to look something like this, right? Where we've got, I don't know, maybe, but little by little, it's going to be linking these things up.
And that's the key thing there that you were drawing before, that the bridge between the two big circles, every point there is always going to be closer to one of the points on the outer circle clusters than it's ever going to be to anything else. And so you're going to end up making one big cluster out of the outer shell, which is kind of weird.
It is a little bit weird. You get these kind of stringy clusters because two things are close to each other if they're close anywhere.
Right.
So, I don't know. To my eye, the best one is the bottom right. But it wouldn't do that because k equals 2.
Right.
So, from what's left, I guess I like the upper right. But that's not what single link clustering would do. It actually would kind of walk around the circle and link things up, like in the lower left.